Okay, welcome back to NASCAR Heat 2 standings as we head into I forgot where I'm 19th with 3 wins. I think I'm locked into the chase, but this is the hot seat season, so who knows. I'm gonna drive the this is Chicagoland. We're gonna be driving for John Hunter Nemechek. I guess he's taking a vacation, so it would make sense to drive Joe Nemechek's truck in this situation, but I guess that doesn't matter. But here we are, Chicagoland. Race length, 25%. We're doing stage races. This is hard difficulty. I should have bumped it up to Legend just because, you know, I've been cleaning a house for the past couple of races, so I want to be good. I want to get good, so. But yeah, I'm probably going to stick with this means of formatting the races as you see them on YouTube for a while. I mean, I know it looks really laggy right now, but we have to kind of live with that. My hard drive just fills up so quickly when you record NASCAR Heat games on Bandicam. I mean, the 1 hour, 45 minute session that you probably only saw like 30 minutes of actual, you know, meat of the content, that's 30 gigabytes in size. I mean, I hearken back to the Texas race that I didn't even finish, and I was recording for like an hour and a half and had 30 gigabytes. So, I mean, I just can't accept that kind of disk space, just gluttony when it comes to the file size. It's nice. Nice ninth place starting spot, though. That's a good position. And it's a Thor Sport top front row. Hope Grant Enfinger pulls it off this weekend. That'd be cool. But yeah. We've got 23 laps on fuel. First stage is 8 laps. I'm doing 2 times wear, in case you're wondering. I don't actually know how long the actual base race is. We don't actually see that until the stage breaks, so. It's tough to determine when you actually want to go down pit road and how much you actually want to put into your truck when you do, so. Chicago's a pretty tough track to drive on. I mean, I don't know if it still drives anything like it does in our 2003. It's a really momentum-based track, and you have one bad lap and you're not having a good time, so yeah, you gotta be really cautious when you're driving at Chicagoland in our 2003, but I guess I'm just putting all that superstition to rest as I completely obliterate the field, and by the field I mean the wall. That's what I'm completely obliterating at this point, so. A little bit of damage, but nothing bad. Nothing race-ending, if you ask me, so. God, I'm just addicted to that outside line, man. I've got Larson syndrome, man. It's contagious. Not really. No one else is running the outside, so. Not that contagious, actually. Oh, sure, the teammates play nicely with each other. They give each other room in the corners. I don't get that kind of luxury, man. We're coming up on the lead. Yeah, I really gotta up the difficulty for the rest of this season, at least. Because this is getting a little bit ridiculous. Even with the, you know, the best truck in the field, 5-star rating, like, this is unacceptable. Levels of domination, so. I shouldn't have to bother with that, you know? You know. I'm supposed to do this project during, like, local noon, but I have classes every day of the week at noon, and I'm supposed to go 3 separate days. The only opportunities that I'm going to have are on the weekends, and I don't even plan to be here on the weekend, and I'm supposed to bring in my 3 test results on Tuesday, so therefore, even if I stayed here, I'd only have 2 opportunities to actually get some information for this shit, so. Yeah. Things just aren't perfect, are they? I guess in a sense they are, because here I am in first, but yeah, that's just a little bit of an infuriating tidbit of my life there. about set the best lap ever. Good job. Good job, old John Hunter. Yeah, I'm just LARPing as these guys at this point. I don't even count this season towards my actual statistics. I just count this towards everyone else's. So, I had something to say. Oh, yeah. I ate nothing on Sunday after, you know, when we had the stream. I had everything that you saw on that stream. Sunday, I had nothing. Monday, I had food. Yesterday, I had nothing. Today, I had food. Tomorrow, I shouldn't eat anything, but I probably will because I'm a fat ass. And then Friday, who knows? But yeah, I feel as thin as ever. Which is crazy to think. I did walk to and from one class today, so that might have helped work off all the stuff that I did eat for lunch. I had 3 pieces of pizza and a burger and fries, and they're damn good burgers here. I used to love the burgers from my other college, but these ones ain't bad either. They're great in their own ways. Like, the ones at my old school were like the perfect fast food burger. Like, they just had a perfect amount of, you know, crappy seasonings, and they were really flat and also square. I do appreciate that they were square because they remind me of Wendy's, but these ones are actually made on the grill, so they are damn good too. And they're kind of smoked a little bit as well, which is nifty. So that's a stage win. Yeah, I really hope I remember that difficulty. Estimated fuel, 15 laps, 21 laps. Yeah, we can't pit now and make it, so no reason to bother. We'll pit at the next stage end. Maybe take 2, maybe take 4. I haven't decided yet. So now we're rolling again. This is stage 2. It's going to be 7 laps instead of 8, so the tension is definitely picking up. And this is very interesting. I guess DMR was actually, or 704 was actually informed of what the stage lengths were going to be. Because, we haven't been to Chicago yet this season in any series, so the fact that they know the stage lengths for here really does tell us that everything is predetermined. Our lives are just a never-ending puppet master relationship, you know? Where everything that we're going to do is already foretold at the beginning, and the story's already written. Yeah. It's a pretty bleak look at life, but, you know, when you've been a fan of the Cubs, Chargers, and Mark Martin your whole life, you're going to have quite a bleak outlook on your life. Did I ever actually make a Cubs win the World Series celebration video? I don't even think I did. I think, just like with everyone else, I was just too surprised that it actually happened. I remember cutting classes. I remember cutting psychology just to watch the parade in Chicago. Like, you know what? This kind of thing is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. I don't want to really miss this. And I didn't even see anything about it afterwards. So it's a good thing I did that then, because I probably wouldn't have any other time. But yeah, if I remember at the stage break, I'll show you what's so significant about this paint scheme that I'm running right now. Got a 32.1, and this is on old tires. 75% on the right front, so. But yeah, we're a second and a half ahead of Kraft, and I mean, this is just a good old-fashioned curb stomp at this point. I really do need to bump up the difficulty at this point. But we all know how that turned out for Dirt to Daytona, or maybe we don't know how that turned out for Dirt to Daytona. Who knows when this will be uploaded? But yeah, there's some foreshadowing if you haven't seen Dirt to Daytona yet, so. Still 3 laps to go in the stage, man. I'm struggling for commentary. I haven't really recorded games for, like, a month now, so you'd think I'd have some pent-up stuff to talk about, and I really have. I really have had a lot to talk about here, so. Considering all the recording that I have done the past couple of days in this game, so, yeah. Not even that bad in the commentary home front, but it could be better, man. It can always be better. Because you never know with this shit sometimes. Barry's Bullets. That's the female version of the name Barry. Interesting. Is it a female gunsmith? Now that'd be breaking some boundaries there. Like, yeah. I hope you're just as entertained by this game as I am, because I really am enjoying this. I don't know how many times I have to say it before, you know, people get sick of it, but I really am enjoying this game so much. It's so nice to have a playable NASCAR game again. And Trucks and Xfinity is just a nice icing on top of the cake. I mean, it's not amazing. This game isn't amazing by any means. It's no Thunder 2004. It's absolutely not, you know, 2005. It's definitely not. And that's not anything made by Papyrus either, but scrape the wall for good measure. Got ourselves another stage win. Yeah. Woohoo. We need to make it 21 laps on fuel. So, here's what I was talking about on the whole significance thing. We have to fill this to full, so we may as well not repair damage. Reduce the wedge just a little bit. I will take all four tires. I'm probably going to drop a lot, but it'll be fine. Yeah, back to 17th. Goodness gracious. I am ready, and I am steady. Yeah, I don't know what you can do to make it on. I don't know what you can do to make up for your pit crew. Like, this is a 5-star team, so the pit crew should be good as well, but I guess it, really the game didn't consider that, because I'd imagine everyone would take 4 tires. Maybe just 2, but definitely had to take 2 cans of fuel. There's no way they're going to make it otherwise. Because unlike in Euro Truck Simulator, where you can actually level up your ability to save fuel, you can't actually do that in this game, so everyone uses the same amount of fuel, man. Which is actually interesting. Actually, Terry Labonte got like a top 5 driving for a grossly underfunded team in a fuel mileage race. I think a lot of that has to do with why the Coke 600 in 2007 top 10 was so wacky and out of order. Because all of the people that were unable to save equipment had, you know, worse, that actually had, you know, better power output, so they were using more fuel, and the ones that didn't have as much power output, you know, they didn't use as much fuel, so that's why guys like Kyle Petty was up in the top 5. I still think Reed Sorensen didn't get a fair shake. I think he could put up some competitive numbers in a good Xfinity car, maybe not a Cup car. But he could still probably handle Xfinity at this point. God, it's hot in this room. This will complete lap 24. I'm getting a little bit of elf piss there. You can actually take that route in real life, but I guess this game didn't really consider that as a viable option. Poor Grant Enfinger, dude. He just keeps getting to the front and dropping back, and getting to the front and dropping back. I mean, it's just an endless cycle for him. Ooh, look at that nice bump there. That was a strategic bump right there. That took some work, dude. That took some work. Yeah, I don't know what to say. I guess I'll find something else to talk about now. I don't actually have a footstool with me, so, or weight stool with me, so I can't actually tell you how much I weigh, so if I actually lost weight or anything, but I couldn't do that right now anyway. You'd have to talk to me in the morning, because in the morning is when you're actually, you know, legitimate weight, because everything's been processed overnight, so after you get up and use the bathroom in the morning, that's the best time to weigh yourself up, man. Lowest that I've been since freshman year of high school would be 162. I really hate myself for... Okay. Oh man, I saved him and everything. And Krafton was just like, you know what? Fuck your race. Dick. I genuinely regret being such a glutton when I was, you know, 15, 14, 15. I just ate so much shit. Basically the same thing happened, in a sense, to what made me start losing all the weight in 2015. But sort of the same thing happened at the end of 2011. Because when I weighed myself when I was... It was 2011, so I was still 13. It was early 2011. It was like January 2011, so... I was 136 then. I was like 13 years, 7, 8 months. More like 10 months. But yeah. I was 136 then. And then like a calendar year later, I was 185, man. I was not good. Then somehow I managed to maintain my weight for some time. And then my first experience with not eating since actually throwing up that... because that's what happened when I was sick the first time. Okay. Okay again. Also okay. I mean, I have no idea why, but okay apparently. I guess we're gonna have aero damage for the rest of the race, so I guess I have been doing way too good in these races, so I guess this does add an element of challenge. Stop wrecking me. I guess they didn't want me to talk about throwing up, and I don't blame them, honestly. Well, now I got absolutely no speed. The only way I'm going to accomplish anything is if a caution comes out, and that's the one thing these guys apparently can't figure out how to fucking program is proper caution detection. Yeah, I mean, look at this. I was flat-footing that corner, and now I can barely get through it this fast. Well, that's just wonderful. That is just fantastic. Can you actually visually... Yes, you can visually see the damage. Okay. Guess it's back to being a back marker, so... Back to the fucking story, I guess. Okay, that took a lot of focus to not go on the apron. Yeah, back to the fucking story, so... But yeah, my first experience with not eating was those 2 days after I threw up, so... That's probably what I had a lot to do with why I maintained it, like, a 136. But then somehow I just gained 50 pounds. Just out of nowhere, just from all the fucking eating that I did between them. The time after that, I actually started paying attention to the fact that I was a fucking fat ass. I mean, holy shit, you'd think someone would at least say something, but they never did. Because since no one said anything, I assumed it didn't actually visually look like I was any fatter. I mean, if someone actually spoke up and said something, I probably wouldn't have eaten like a fucking idiot. Probably would have been sensible about it at least, but you know how it is, man. You know how it is. But now I've mastered, basically. I've mastered not eating at this point. I mean, yesterday I wanted to eat at night, but I didn't. And when I woke up this morning, I wasn't even hungry. I mean, that's the point that I've gotten to in this whole not eating thing. And it's fine. I mean, I'm not falling apart by any means. I mean, my thumb is getting numb occasionally, but that's just because of the stupid controller. Not being ergonomically designed and all that shit. It has nothing to do with the not eating, so. Yeah. My goal for 2015 was actually lose. £35. I wanted to be 150 to 155 at the end of the year. And the fact that I was down to 165, because I also went through a spurt where I got back into the 170s again. And the biggest thing about the not eating thing is that the second time that I got sick and I wasn't eating for a couple of days, the second time that that happened was when I was, you know, trying to lose weight and I was just stuck at 185 and I couldn't do anything. But when I got, when I couldn't eat those couple of days, I was down to 175 that quickly in just a week's time, and I was like, you know what, there might be something to this whole starvation thing. No wonder all those guys in Africa have all those amazing physiques. It's because they don't fucking eat. And so began my long campaign to not be fat. That has been successful. It is a successful campaign. I feel amazing these days. But, I mean, not eating really does impact your motivation to do things. I mean, after eating today, I had a lot more confidence in my work. I was a lot more energetic. And, you know, seeing as how a lot of energy, you know, comes from food, you know, that makes complete sense. It's just, man, strange that food packed with energy would give you energy, man. Carl Sagan couldn't even explain this if he tried, man. It's just crazy. But, yeah. I don't know where to go from there. I think the story's kind of dead at this point. I do have a video of myself explaining how I lost 20 pounds, gained some of it back, and then kind of worked my way back to where I am now. It was actually for class. I think it's still on the channel. Should be. But we're finally coming to a white flag sponsored by Credit One Bank lap. I have absolutely no speed. And I haven't had speed since, well, we're not going to talk about it, are we? But in any case, yeah, this is just... And this is going to be the first race that I don't actually get the winnings for, so... That's annoying. It was 42,000 instead of just 40,000 that time, so... That's great. That's going to be a black eye on this impeccable season I've had so far. But it's still better than I probably would have done in another fire truck, so... And somehow I got 16th, even though I was in 17th that whole time. Whatever you say, game, whatever you say. God, it's so hot in here. I'm just sweating. I just got a... Just a sheet. Just a sheet of sweat on the back of my neck here. I did win both stages, I'm pretty sure, but that's not going to mean anything in the contract sense of things. Getting somewhere. Keep working hard and you'll get there. Congratulations on reaching 500 fans. Oh, I didn't even know fans were in this game. It's really the first milestone you reach. Alright, if you say so. I think I just got the same trophy again. Oh, and I guess the season's over. Alright, well, that was unexpected. I guess we're going to take a look at the contracts and sign for a team. So, 7 teams available. I have to say, that's pretty good. So, we could drive the actual Corbin Forrester truck and kick him out of the car for the year. Could drive a custom truck with Corbin as a teammate. Oh, I have a lot of money if I can put that towards upgrades. That's actually something that I might think about doing. We could drive a premium motorsports truck. We could drive a Jennifer Joe Cobb truck, a Hattori truck. Austin Hill would be neat. He's not that great though. Yeah. Got KBM. I could just steal. I could drive anything for KBM, dude. Wow. No way. I could take anyone's ride that I want. I don't know what I want, dude. This is a lot of cool choices, though. I'm putting myself in a bad spot by doing this, but I so want to be teammates with Corbin. Oh, man, that'd be great. Does it actually change the manufacturers? I think it keeps going to Ford here. Okay, let's actually jump over to the... Yeah, it's definitely not a Chevy when you're doing a custom truck for them, but it's definitely a Ford if you do it there, so. This is a tough decision. I'm not sure who I want to take. I would like KBM just because they're so easy to drive, you know. But. Dude, I don't know who to pick. I could just steal Cindric's car. The fact that that Kyle Busch is giving me free reign of any of his trucks, that's nice. You know what? I'm going to be Noah Gregson for the season. It says I can use custom car, but I'm guessing. Oh yeah, that's just giving you the option to do it if you want to run for KBM and a custom car. They're actually giving you the choice of doing whichever one you want, but they didn't have enough room on the menu, I suppose, for a custom. And yeah, I don't know. But I mean, it's going to be a Ford if I do the custom truck anyway, so it won't match up, so we may as well go with KBM. We're going to drive this. So I am now on KBM. Currently competes in the trucks and the late models. Interesting. Well, now that's my team. So it begins. Very interesting way to say that game. You can probably actually see the little notifications there. But I am signed with KBM. I don't want to sign, no. You can actually change that over the course of the season. That's cool. Teams. Seven teams interested. Okay, I guess there is no way to upgrade your. Or maybe you do. Maybe you press start season one. But we're not going to do that now in case there's a cutscene, so I'm just going to end it off the part right now. So that was fun. We are going to be driving for KBM, so that's good. Going to have some winning speed. And before I forget, let's crank up that difficulty. I actually can't. Okay. Never mind. Next time we'll crank up the difficulty, but until then, this has been Kamikaze Games playing some more NASCAR Heat 2, and I will see you in whatever it is I make next. Goodbye.